Lecture 3, Part 4, Molecular Genetics. Such questions will be discussed. Transcription, mRNA processing in eukaryotes, capping, polyadenylation, splicing, reverse transcription, and medical aspects of transcription. Question 3.5, Transcription. Transcription is a naturally occurring process of constructing a molecule of ribonucleic acid, mRNA, tRNA, or rRNA, using a DNA molecule as a template. During transcription, genetic information is transferred to the newly formed molecule of mRNA. The information in RNA is still written in essentially the same language as it is in DNA, the language of a nucleotide sequence, hence the name transcription. Like DNA, RNA contains the bases adenine, guanine, and cytosine. It contains the base uracil instead of the thymine in DNA. U, like T, can base pair by hydrogen bonding with A. The enzyme that performs transcription is called RNA polymerase, or DNA-dependent RNA polymerase. The RNA polymerase unwinds the DNA helix at its active site, forming a transcription bubble, moves stepwise along the DNA, adds ribonucleotides one by one to the RNA chain at the polymerization site using an exposed DNA strand as a template. It catalyzes the formation of the phosphodiester bonds that link the nucleotides together to form a linear chain. In this picture, you can find 3D model of RNA polymerase. Site of nucleotide addition, RNA, in short, DNA-RNA helix. Template DNA strand is in red. Displaced non-template DNA strand in yellow. And newly synthesized RNA transcript in blue. RNA polymerase elongates an RNA strand by adding ribonucleotides to the 3' hydroxyl end, building RNA in the 5' to 3' direction. The protein requires, in addition to a DNA template, all four ribonucleoside 5' triphosphates ATP, GTP, CTP, and UTP as precursors of the nucleotide units of RNA, as well as magnesium 2+ and zinc 2+. A transcription unit is a stretch of DNA that encodes a single RNA molecule and the sequences necessary for its transcription. It includes 3 critical regions, a promoter, an RNA coding region, and a terminator. In this picture, we can find the structure of a gene. Promoter determines transcription start site. It is indicated by +1 nucleotide. To the right, we can find downstream nucleotides. To the left, upstream nucleotides. Transcription starts at promoter and stops at the terminator. Before protein coding sequence, we can find 5' untranslated region, and after stop codon, we can find 3' untranslated region. Only one DNA strand is transcribed. It is called template strand. Another strand is not transcribed. It is called non-template strand. Promoter is a special sequence of nucleotides that serves as a recognition signal for an RNA polymerase. It indicates the direction of transcription, the starting point for RNA synthesis, and the rate of transcription. When RNA polymerase binds to DNA, it finds promoter and moves at the direction that is determined by promoter. In our picture, to the right. Promoters are typically 20 to 150 base pairs long, depending on the organism. Viral, bacterial, or eukaryotic promoters have their own specific consensus sequences for binding to proteins. For example, in this picture we can find the structure of bacterial promoter. It has special consensus sequences, -10 and -35. The RNA polymerases in bacteria are able to recognize particular promoter sequences without the help of any other cellular proteins. In eukaryotes, RNA polymerases are directed to the promoter site by general transcription factors, GTFs, proteins that bind to the DNA near the start site, and provide a docking site for attachment of the polymerase enzyme. Another class of accessory proteins consists of transcriptional activator proteins, which bind to specific DNA sequences, enhances, and bring about high levels of transcription by stimulating the assembly of the RNA polymerase GTFS complex at the start site. Enhancers can affect the transcription of genes that are thousands of nucleotides away, and their positions relative to start sites can vary. An enhancer may be upstream or downstream from the affected gene, or in some cases within the gene itself. Often the enhancer contains the sequence ATTTGCAT. Transcription begins with initiation, continues with elongation, and ends with termination. In initiation, the RNA polymerase recognizes the promoter, opens up a short stretch of the DNA, the transcription bubble is formed, and creates the first bond between two RNTPs, ribonuclear triphosphates. The first nucleotide residue in a nascent, newly formed RNA molecule has the 5' triphosphate group. Because complementary nucleic acid strands are oppositely oriented, the fact that RNA is synthesized 5' to 3' means that the template strand must be oriented 3' to 5'. The RNA transcript has the same polarity and base sequence as does the non-template strand, with the exception that U in RNA substitutes for T in DNA. Hence, the non-template strand is also called the coding strand. Some scientists refer to the non-template and template strands as sense and nonsense strands, or sometimes sense and antisense. In elongation, the RNA polymerase continues opening the DNA helix and synthesizing mRNA by adding RNTPs to the 3' end until the entire transcriptional unit is transcribed. RNA polymerase moves downstream, progressively adding nucleotides to the RNA molecule according to the sequences on the template DNA strand. A phosphodiester bond is created between the two nucleotides and pyrophosphate is released. As the RNA polymerase moves along the DNA, it unwinds the DNA ahead of it and rewinds the DNA that has already been transcribed. Topoisomerases, like gyrase, rapidly regulate the level of supercholine in transcription, as they do in DNA replication. Elongation in eukaryotes is enhanced by special elongation factors. In bacterial cells at 37 degrees of centigrade, about 40 nucleotides are added per second. This rate of RNA synthesis is much lower than that of DNA synthesis, which is more than 1,500 nucleotides per second in bacterial cells. Termination of transcription is the recognition of the end of the transcription unit, the terminator, and the separation of the RNA molecule from the DNA template. Transcription stops after the terminator has been copied into RNA, the polymerase halts and releases both the DNA template and the newly made RNA chain. The bacterial terminator has inverted repeats. After RNA synthesis, such inverted repeats form RNA hairpin that is recognized by RNA polymerase. The segment of DNA between the promoter and the terminator is called a transcription unit or transcriptome. RNA polymerases lack a separate proofreading 3' to 5' exonuclease activity. It makes about one mistake for every 10,000, 100,000 nucleotides copied into RNA, compared with an error rate for direct copying by DNA polymerase of about 1 in 10 million nucleotides. But these errors are not inherited. Because many copies of RNA are generally produced from a single gene, and all RNAs are eventually degraded and replaced, a mistake in an RNA molecule is of less consequence to the cell than a mistake in the permanent information stored in DNA. In bacteria, more than one gene may reside in a transcription unit. A polycistronic mRNA is synthesized. The typical mRNA of eukaryotic cells is monocistronic mRNA coding for a single polypeptide chain. Hence, what is a gene? In molecular genetics, a gene is a specific nucleotide sequence of DNA or RNA in RNA-containing viruses that encodes a single gene product. It is a polypeptide, transfer RNA, ribosomal RNA, or other types of RNA. Now we can find principal types of RNAs produced in cells. mRNAs, or messenger RNAs, they code for proteins. rRNAs, or ribosomal RNAs, they form the basic structure of the ribosome and catalyze protein synthesis. tRNAs, or transfer RNAs, central to protein synthesis as adapters between mRNA and amino acids. Other types of RNAs produced in cells. miRNAs, microRNAs. They are single-stranded, non-coding RNAs that are normally 19 to 30 nucleotides long and are involved in regulation a large percent of human genes. snRNAs, small nuclear RNAs. They function in a variety of nuclear processes, including the splicing of pre-mRNA. snoRNAs, small nuclearly RNAs, used to process and chemically modify rRNAs. And other non-coding RNAs, they function in diverse cellular processes, including telomere synthesis, X chromosome inactivation, and the transport of proteins into the endoplasmic reticulum. Question 3.6. mRNA processing in eukaryotes. In eukaryotes, messenger RNA is synthesized in the nucleus, but protein synthesis takes place in the cytoplasm. Before eukaryotic messenger RNA leaves the nucleus, it is highly modified by processes that generally do not occur in prokaryotes. These modifications are collectively referred to as post-transcriptional processing of mRNA, or mRNA processing. A newly synthesized RNA molecule is called a primary transcript, pre-messenger RNA, or pre-mRNA, whereas the mature processed transcript is mRNA. mRNA processing includes three stages: capping, polydenylation, and splicing. Capping. Capping is the addition of a special cap structure, or cap, at the 5' end of the pre-mRNA. Capping is carried out by special capping enzymes and takes place rapidly after the initiation of transcription. A 5' cap is a residue of 7-methyl guanosine linked to the 5' terminal residue of the mRNA through an unusual 5'-5' triphosphate linkage. Additional methyl groups are often added to the first and second nucleotides adjacent to the cap. In our picture, each nucleotide is indicated by such large arrow. To the left, we can find 5' end of the nucleotide. To the right, we can find 3' end of the nucleotide. Hydroxyl group is added to the 3' end of the nucleotide. Pay attention that the cap structure has an opposite orientation. To the right, 5' end, to the left, 3' end. Three phosphate groups are located between cap structure and the first nucleotide of the mRNA. Both nucleotides are methylated, guanosine of the cap structure and the first nucleotide of the mRNA. The 5' cap provides stability to the mRNA. It helps protect mRNA from ribonucleases and allows the ribosome to recognize the beginning of a messenger RNA. It is a point of attachment for the small subunit of the ribosome. If 5' capping of pre-mRNA does not take place, splicing, stability, and translation of the RNA are all affected. First, the lack of a 5' cap will affect the removal of introns. Second, mRNA that lacks a 5' cap is less stable and will quickly degrade compared with mRNA that has a 5' cap. Finally, if mRNA lacking a 5' cap is transported into the cytoplasm, the ribosome will not recognize the mRNA, and the mRNA will then degrade. Polyadenylation. RNA processing continues with polyadenylation. First, a part of the 3' end of the pre-mRNA is cut off by an end nuclease shortly after the 3' consensus sequence, AAU-AAA. Then, from 50 to 250 adenine ribonucleotides are added by polyadenylate polymerase to create a poly-A tail. These nucleotides are not encoded in the DNA. The poly-A tail confers stability on many mRNAs, increasing the time during which the mRNA remains intact and available for translation before it is degraded by cellular enzymes. The tail also appears to control the movement of the mRNA across the nuclear envelope. The third step of mRNA processing is splicing. In many eukaryotic genes, RNA coding regions consist of coding regions called exons, which are sequences that express a code for a polypeptide, and introns, non-coding intervening sequences that are never translated into protein sequences. They have no information about amino acids. The removal of introns and the joining of exons is called splicing because it is reminiscent of the way in which videotape or movie film can be cut and rejoined to edit out a specific segment. Splicing brings together the coding regions, the exons, so that the mRNA now contains a coding sequence that completely corresponds to the protein that it encodes. Genes with introns are called split genes. In this picture, we can find the scheme that describes synthesis and processing of eukaryotic pre-mRNA. The first stage, A, transcription starts from 5' end to the 3' end. Promoter determines direction of transcription and the first nucleotide that will be incorporated into the growing mRNA strand. B, capping, the adding of special cap structure. C, transcription ends. Terminator determines end of transcription. Now pre-mRNA consists of 5' cap structure, 5' untranslated region, exons, introns, and 3' untranslated region. The next stage is polyadenylation. Then introns are removed and exons are spliced together. Letter E indicates introns that are released as a lariat. Almost all eukaryotic genes have at least one intron. The maximum number of introns in any one gene is 200. The number and size of introns varies from gene to gene and from species to species. In eukaryotic mRNAs, most exons are less than 1,000 nucleotides long, with many in the 100 to 200 nucleotide size range, encoding stretches of 30 to 60 amino acids within a lone polypeptide. Introns vary in size from 50 to 50,000 nucleotides. The average size of an intron is about 2,000 nucleotides. Thus, a larger percentage of the DNA in most multicellular organisms encodes introns, not exons. Genes of higher eukaryotes, including humans, typically have much more DNA devoted to introns than to exons. An extreme example is the human Duchenne muscular dystrophy gene. This gene has 79 exons and 78 introns spread across 2.5 million base pairs. When spliced together, its 79 exons produce an mRNA of 14,000 nucleotides only. This mRNA encodes a protein called dystrophin, which consists of nearly 4,000 amino acids. Splicing starts when RNA is still being synthesized and after the cap has been added, but before the transcript is transported into the cytoplasm. Splicing continues until all introns are removed. Large complex consisting of several small nuclear RNAs, snRNAs, and many proteins that splices protein-encoding pre-mRNA is called a spliceosome. The spliceosome recognizes special consensus sequences that mark the beginnings and endings of introns. However, some introns have the ability to remove themselves from the mRNA strand without the help of the spliceosome. Most interns in pre-mRNA begin with GU and end with AG, suggesting that these sequences play a crucial role in splicing. Changing a single nucleotide at either of these sites does indeed prevent splicing. Sometimes introns and exons can be spliced out to create a new sequence of exons. This process is called alternative splicing. The use of multiple polydenylation signals is called alternative polydenylation. Both alternative splicing and polyadenylation can produce different mRNAs and subsequently different proteins from the same primary transcript. Thanks to alternative splicing, the 30,000 or so genes in humans are able to produce around 90,000 different proteins. In this picture, we can find alternative pathways for processing pre-mRNA. Suppose double-stranded DNA has 4 exons and 3 introns, number 1, number 2, and number 3. Pre-mRNA also has 4 exons and 3 introns. It has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 polydenylation signals that are indicated by S. Arrow B indicates different variants of alternative splicing. The first variant is normal splicing. All 3 introns are removed. Then suppose that intron 2 and intron 3 will be removed with exon 3. Cancer mRNA will have only 3 exons, E1, E2, and E4. Intron 1 and intron 2 can be removed with exon 2. We can find such 3 exons in mRNA, E1, E3, and E4. Also, all 3 introns can be removed with 2 exons, number 2 and number 3. And mature mRNA will have only 2 exons, E1 and E4. In the picture to the right, we can find different variants of alternative polydenylation. The first S signal can be used and poly-A-tail will be synthesized. The second S that is located inside exon 4 also can be used as polydenylation signal. Hence, exon 4 will be shorter. Another polydenylation signal that is located inside intron 3 will be used as a signal for polydenylation. And we can find that mature mRNA will have exon 1, exon 2, exon 3, and other variants of polydenylation also can occur. The mature and correctly processed mRNA is transported out of the nucleus and into the cytoplasm, where translation by a ribosome can take place. Since the discovery of introns, geneticists have been trying to figure out why they exist. Several views have arisen. Walter Gilbert suggested that introns separate exons, coding regions, into functional domains. That is, they separate different exons that presumably have specific tasks. In a given protein, one exon might code for a membrane-binding region, one might code for the active site of the enzyme, and one might code for ATPase activity. By recombinational mechanisms, or by excluding an exon during intron removal, exon shuffling would allow the rapid evolution of new proteins, whose structures would be conglomerates of various functional domains. Question 3.7. Reverse transcription. Reverse transcription is the process of DNA synthesis from an RNA template mediated by reverse transcriptase, RNA-directed DNA polymerase. Some viruses that contain RNA instead of DNA can convert the RNA back into a DNA copy using this enzyme. The DNA copy then integrates into the host chromosome to form a provirus, which is replicated by host enzymes when the host chromosome is duplicated. Later, such infected cell begins to make copies of the viral genes in the form of messenger RNA and viral proteins. Such RNA viruses are called retroviruses. An example of a retrovirus is human immunodeficiency virus that attacks the immune system and causes AIDS, acquired immune deficiency syndrome. many carcinogenic viruses, they cause a carcinoma or cancer, are retroviruses. Reverse transcription is used in gene engineering. Question 3.8. Medical aspects of transcription. Bacteria contain a single type of RNA polymerase which produces all types of RNA. In eukaryotic cells, there are three RNA polymerases. RNA polymerase 1 makes the ribosomal RNAs, excluding small rRNAs. RNA polymerase 2 transcribes mRNA, snRNAs, and some snRNAs. RNA polymerase 3 transcribes tRNAs, small rRNAs, and some snRNAs. In addition, mitochondria and chloroplasts have other RNA polymerases. Bacterial and eukaryotic RNA polymerases have different properties, hence some substances, antibiotics, can be used against bacteria. Bacterial RNA polymerases are inhibited by rifampicins produced by Streptomyces mediterranea, including rifampicin, an important antibiotic used to treat tuberculosis. It blocks initiation of transcription. The antibiotic actinomycin D, produced by the bacterium Streptomyces chrysomallus, inserts, intercalates into the double helical DNA between two successive GC base pairs, deforming the DNA. This prevents movement of the RNA polymerase along the template. Actinomycin D inhibits transcription in both bacteria and eukaryotes. The death cap mushroom, Amanita phalloides, and other fungi, Amanita virosa, Chlorophyllum molybditis, Galerina species, have evolved a very effective defense mechanism against predators. They produce toxic cyclic peptides, amatoxins, such as amanitin and phalloidin. Alpha-amanitin, a small peptide, disrupts mRNA formation in animal cells by blocking RNA polymerase 2 and, at higher concentrations, RNA polymerase 3. Bacterial RNA polymerases and the RNA polymerase 2 of these fungi are resistant to alpha-amanitin. Amanitin is deadly in very small dosage, 5 mg. The initial reaction to ingestion of the mushroom is gastrointestinal distress caused by some of the other toxins. These symptoms disappear, but about 48 hours later, the mushroom eater dies, usually from liver dysfunction. In the picture to the right, we can find 3D model of RNA polymerase 2. Incorrect splicing that is caused by a mutation can lead to disease. Phenylketonuria, PKU, or felin disease, is a hereditary disorder of amino acid metabolism. It is an autosomal recessive disease caused by a disturbance of synthesis of tyrosine from phenylalanine. As a result, a patient has high level of phenylalanine and phenylpyruvic acid in the blood, liquor, and urine. This leads to severe mental retardation, tumors, seizures, hyperpigmentation of hair and skin, eczema, and other symptoms. PKU is caused by more than 450 different mutations, deletions, insertions in the PAH gene, which encodes phenylalanine hydroxylase. The most frequent mutant allele in Caucasians is a base substitution in the left border of the 12th intron. GU changes into AU as a result of transition, G into A. This intron is not removed, translation continues on the intron sequence, and then terminates at the unexpected stop codon. Premature chain termination leads to formation of inactive enzyme.